My name is Justin Hill, and I'm here today with Andrew Marbury. Both of us work for FWC's Fish and Wildlife Research Institute in the Freshwater Fisheries Research Section. And today we are going to talk about work going on in the St. Johns River and specifically Silver Glen Springs with our striped bass and hybrid striped bass populations that live there. Andrew, could you tell me a little bit of history of striped bass in the St. Johns River?
Yeah. So historically, the St. Johns River was home to the southernmost native population of Atlantic strain striped bass. But natural reproduction was low, we think, and it ceased completely by the 1970s due to habitat fragmentation and degradation. And as a result of that, we have started stocking striped bass and sunshine bass, which are a hybrid between stripers and white bass. So that's been stocked by both FWC and U.S. Fish and Wildlife Service. And we've been essentially looking to replace that fishery. So to gather the data on this population of stocked fish, we've been using a seasonal concentration at Silver Glen Springs. It's a spring system, very clear water, so we're able to get in there and visually assess the population really easily. We get in there with snorkel equipment, take pictures, and we're able to get a good idea of the general health of the population, as well as general abundances and stocking proportions.
What research are you currently conducting at the spring?
Currently, we've been doing a telemetry project. So we've been tracking sunshine bass, particularly in this one, throughout the Middle St. Johns River system. We have 25 sunshine bass that are tagged with an acoustic tag. And what that does is it sends a ping every 60 seconds. It sends a ping out. And we have a receiver array located throughout the area, and each receiver location actually is listening for a ping. So anytime a tagged fish swims by that receiver location, we get a ping of the fish and we know where that fish has been.
Why tracking with acoustic telemetry?
Yeah, so we're using acoustic. The other tracking method would be radio telemetry. And we're using specifically acoustic because the salt levels in the St. Johns River are too high for the radio tags. The signal attenuates, so it's harder to track them. So that acoustic tag would be a lot easier to track the movements.
What brought about the decision to start tracking the fish?
So when we were looking at, we're doing our typical assessments in the spring there at Silver Glen, and we're seeing the fish there for such a long period of time, 6 months. By the end of the year, they're looking real skinny and unhealthy. And we're wondering, hey, do they even have the ability to move around? Are they moving out of the spring, you know, at night to go try and feed at least? Are they moving to other spring systems? There's an abundance of them in the St. John's. So we really wanted to look at what other systems than Silver Glen are they utilizing.
Have you found anything interesting so far in the research?
Yeah, so what we've seen is the fish move around the system throughout the year, but especially in the summer months when they're restricted to thermal refuge. They actually, in Florida, when water temperatures get over 25 degrees Celsius in the summer, they're actually all restricted to some sort of cool water refuge, right? So it has to be under 25 degrees Celsius. And where we find that is all the spring systems. So we've been seeing these striped bass and these sunshine bass move into the spring systems in March or so, and they stay until October. So they're staying there for upwards of 6 months in that system just for that cool water refuge. We definitely have seen a lot of them move into Silver Glen. The vast majority of them actually have been, 60% go to Silver Glen as thermal refuge. But we've seen fish use Juniper Springs, Salt Springs, Blue Springs, and the Croaker Hole as well, to a lesser degree.
Where do you see research at the spring going forward, and what do you hope to find?
So going forward, we're going to continue our visual assessments of the population. We do that every year on a weekly to monthly basis just to get a good idea of how many fish are using Silver Glen throughout the year. But this actual telemetry project is finishing up right now. It's been about a year and a half, and the tags are set to expire. So I'm going to go out, hopefully in the next few weeks, and download the receiver array for good, get a really good idea, closer look at where these fish have been moving. And potentially the goal would be to expand the receiver array. We actually had a couple fish leave upstream and downstream of where we were able to place the receivers. And it would be interesting to be able to expand that array and see where they're moving upstream or downstream, where exactly they're going.
All right. Thank you for your time, Andrew.
All right. Thank you.